Shall I start?
Yes. I'm audible to you, sir.
हाँ जी आसिफ सर
जी हाँ. वन मोर थिंग सर, द स्टूडेंट्स आर कंफ्यूज्ड बिकॉज यू नो दिस प्रीलिम्स एग्जाम वाज सपोज्ड टू बी कंडक्टेड इन द मंथ ऑफ जून, सॉरी अप्रैल, नॉट जून. इट वाज सपोज्ड टू बी कंडक्टेड इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल. नाउ इट गॉट पोस्टपोन टू अक्टूबर. नाउ द स्टूडेंट्स आर कंफ्यूज्ड वेदर टू यू नो प्रिपेयर द करंट अफेयर स्टिल यू नो द मार्च जस्ट वन बिफोर एज पर द अर्लियर शेड्यूल और शैल बी प्रिपेयर इट इन अक्टूबर. व्हाट आई हैव सजेस्टेड टू द स्टूडेंट, आई हैव आस्क्ड हिम टू कंटिन्यू रीडिंग न्यूज़पेपर, कीप अपडेटेड योरसेल्फ, बिकॉज if you do not keep ourselves updated and if we keep reading the newspaper or you know current affairs till you know September, October, because it could be a possibility that in mains exam UPSC might ask questions from that period where we have skipped it. So because you know the mains exam is supposed to be conducted in the month of December now, and since mains question paper is not you know yet prepared or it is not set, but ho sakta hai in prelims they might not ask a question from this you know the period between you know May to or maybe October, but there could be a possibility that UPSC deliberately they might ask question from this period in the mains exam. So that's why I have suggested them to continue reading newspaper, even if the question paper might not you know it must have been set before the April exam. So that's what I have suggested. You can give your suggestion related to this doubt about the students about the current affairs.
There should be no doubt about this right now. You should prepare current affairs at least 1 month, like at least till August. If it's scheduled on October 10, don't keep doubt in your mind, because by doubt, what happens exactly is it breaks your flow, it breaks your momentum. So don't keep doubt. See, with UPSC, nobody knows about how they set the paper exactly, how many days before they set the paper. There is possibility, like we used to believe that they always set paper around 10 days before, because that keeps the paper kind of a thing. If you fix it too early, the possibility of getting leaked somewhere, et cetera, are more. So they keep it always, like, I think 30 days before and all that, they can make edits anytime. And remember this also, till the time of March and all that, since everything was about COVID, so there won't be much current affairs in that part. All right. This year, the current affairs has quite changed, because earlier what used to happen exactly is there used to be so many international events, so many international happenings and all that, and you had to keep yourself abreast with that. But off late, what has happened last 2 years have been all about COVID. So that day, in a way, has restricted the size of current affairs. So you should ideally prepare current affairs till August at least. Like you should be done with August by now. You should have read newspaper. And उसके अगर आपने छोटे छोटे notes बनाए हैं खुद से, you should revise that. Or what some students do is they read newspaper, they don't make those comprehensive notes, and then they refer to some comprehensive coverage of the coaching centers. That's also equally good. But I always suggest read newspaper every day. Read newspaper every day. That's for future also. Read newspaper every day. Make sure you make some brief notes, because this examination is not about reading. It's about revision and retention. Everybody reads otherwise. The people who are able to retain more through revision, those people find place in the final list. That is about current affairs. Hope this answers the question. Do we have any other queries, or should I move forward?
Sir, there were lot, so many questions from agriculture the part.
Somebody is asking something. Omar.
Sir, there were so many questions from agriculture part last year. So, should we refer some specific book for agriculture, or like should we do it from the current affairs only? Because Indian Forest Services IFS candidate and aspirants, they are also giving exams with us only. Current affairs only.
Yes, sir. Current affairs. No need to specifically refer to any agriculture book. No need to refer to any agriculture book. See, for a particular agriculture, at the end of the day, is one part of the economy. It's not whole of the economy. If you read one book for agriculture, that will come at the cost of other subjects, the other part of the economy. So don't boggle yourself too much by agriculture. Read from the current affairs only, and zyada facts bhi yaad nahi rakhne hain about. We have a tendency at times, we feel that agriculture is the most important thing of Indian economy, so we end up mugging up too many facts about agriculture that end of the day create some confusion. Theek hai, don't put all of your energy in agriculture only.
Yes sir, thank you.
Got it. Acha, So we are done with revision part. ठीक है ना, revision part I said कि everything has to be revised that you have read till now regarding the prelims. Second thing I told you about comprehensive tests. Right now it's the time to appear, what do you call as attempt more and more comprehensive tests. And meanwhile, whatever section you are feel you are weak in, and that section has a good weightage. For example, ancient history, etc., etc. That has a good weightage in the examinations. Please make sure you read that, you do it through these comprehensive test papers. Take the section of that, like they come with sectional paths also. Take those comprehensive test papers out, or those sectional test papers, mock test papers. Make sure you attempt more from that part wherein you find yourself uncomfortable and uneasy. Now, about the examination day, I would like to tell you one thing about the examination day, because that is something that's in my mind right now. See, when it comes to the examination day, you have to make sure during the examination only you gauge the difficulty level of the examination. See, what happens exactly is there are so many people when it comes to prelims qualification, there are so many people who get stuck at the borderline. Borderline in the sense, either they get, because of the when the question key comes, etc., etc., they are somewhere around that border mark. They are somewhere around the threshold where the cutoff is predicted. To make sure, like you, for example, if you have prepared well, to make sure you cross that threshold somehow, you have to gauge the difficulty level of the exam paper during the paper itself. During the exam, do one thing: take any four random questions twice. Like, for example, you are attempting the question. For example, if you reach it, if you are right now attempting the question number 10, see 10 to 14 questions, four questions. If you are able to attempt four questions on the trot and you are able to swallow them perfectly, gauge the examination, difficulty of the examination level is to be as to be easy. Like, for example, the merit will be on the higher side. Okay. In that case, your attempts should be proportionately more. Because kya ho jata hai kabhi kabhi, see, I have seen many people, they are not able to, like, consistently they have failed in prelims examination just because they are somehow not able to cross that plus minus one mark wala threshold. What happens exactly in their cases, either they attempt too many questions and because of the negative marks they are pulled down, or in an easy paper, some people do this thing, they are more conservative. In an easy paper, they end up attempting less questions, uski wajah se kya ho jata hai, the merit goes high and they are left back. So during the examination, try to figure out ki yaar examination ka level kya hai, and on that basis try to make an intelligent guess or try to make an intelligent decision there. Should I go and attempt the questions more or should I restrict myself? Ek to ye element, and second, it also depends on your what you call as result, temporary result in the mock tests. Agar aapka guesswork wahan pe, those questions jahan pe aap intelligent guess lagate ho, agar aapka guesswork acha jata hai, there are some people, I'll tell you, unke haath mein, their hands are such, they put mark on a particular option and that is right. There are some people like that. And there are some people, whenever they make any intelligent guess, they end up turning wrong. ठीक है, try and figure out during the mock tests in itself which category you are. If you are that category who is poor at making intelligent guesses, don't extra attempt. If you are that guy jiske guesses theek ho jate hain, those intelligent guesses, I'm not talking about any wild guesses, because if there's a question in prelims jiski aapko koi bhi khabar nahi hai, don't attempt that. But yes, go through the options. At times kya ho jata hai, whatever happens in the options, at least don't just ignore one question. This will be one more principle I'll tell you, or one more tip I'll tell you. Don't just underestimate any easy question. Always remember, if the question appears easy, there might be a catch. There might be a catch in terms of, for example, the numbers like less than this, minimum of this, more or less, phrases like these will be in the options. So apparently on the face of it, the question that seems easy, try to read it twice before attempting and before marking it. ठीक है ना, that जो भी आपको question बहुत easy लगे, try to do that. And when it comes to difficult questions, the question that appears to be very difficult by the options, or apparently finds it, you find it difficult, there will be some key in the options itself. UPSC balances it that way. Jo koi easy question hoga, there will be a catch. So there's a tendency you might get caught in that catch, and that will be that question, that kind of the question that at the end of the day you'll put your finger between your teeth. Are yaar ye kya ho gaya, itna easy question galat ho gaya. Theek hai, so make sure you do it at that point of the time, and make sure you practice it consciously during your mock tests. Jo bhi easy question lagta hai, try to read it twice. Jo bhi difficult question lagta hai, extra difficult, try to figure out, might be there's a possibility options mein kuch extreme hoga ya options mein there might be some key. And second thing I told you about trying to gauge the difficulty level and see, that's part of that. See, I'll tell you, certain things happen in the examination. You don't prepare for that. It comes to you naturally, instinctually at that point of time. And trust your instincts at that point of time. If the instinct tells you you have to restrict yourself in over attempting, do it. If it tells you how by paper easy hai, I have to make some more questions. Jahan pe aapko do options aa rahe hain yaar, do 50-50% you are sure, make sure you do accordingly. It's all about taking that fine step or taking that leap. You should have faith in yourself. Theek hai, this is about how you attempt exactly those questions. Ab aaj ki date mein, since you have only 40 days left, tell me this thing, I need at least 2 or 3 participants to respond. Have you read the NCERT standard books? 2 or 3 participants can at least respond. Anybody who hasn't read NCERT books?
For a few subjects, yes, sir. But for a few subjects, it's not opted. For subjects like geography and for subjects like history, it was referred up to a certain level. But, you know, the books which has big standard books like polity, it wasn't referred. You know, it was anonymously neglected.
That's all right. That's as you said in Lakshmikant, that's a good way in fact to go. For example, jaise Lakshmikant hai, usme aapko prelims point of view, but I'll suggest mains jab aapka hoga, read that Introduction to Indian Constitution. That's a nice book. Theek hai. While as you said, make sure geography ki jo aapki textbooks hai, NCERTs, you have read that. Make sure history ki jo aapki NCERT ki textbooks hai, especially ancient history and fine arts. I won't suggest medieval, etc. is like thoda kam aate hain questions. But yes, ancient history mein NCERT is there, and fine arts, there's an NCERT book. I don't know what reference books you might have read in case of ancient, because ancient history mein we used to read that there was some guy by the name, I'm forgetting the exact name.
R.S. Sharma
is the standard textbook. R.S. Sharma is the standard textbook. There used to be some coaching center material also about fine arts. There's one material. Not Roman.
So what about Nitin Singhania for fine arts?
Nitin Singhania. Huh. Have you read that?
Yes, sir. That's why I'm asking this.
Whosoever has read that, he should reread that. That is what I'm saying. Because if you have read it, reread that in these 40 days, and plus read at least the fine arts NCERT book. Because it will be, again, it will be less than that. Fine arts NCERT book will be only 50 pages. But it will be compact. It will have certain facts that will be important and all that. It won't be very difficult for you, one who has read Singhania. So for the people who has read Nitin Singhania, he should reread that in these 40 days. And plus, he should make sure he goes through that fine arts book at least once. For the person who has not read Nitin Singhania right now, I believe he would have read that NCERT book. He should revise that well. And plus, he should, as per the trend, like for example, dances, etc., and the things like puppetry, etc., he should refer Nitin Singhania for those parts only. If he has time, he should refer to some parts of Nitin Singhania. He should not try to pick it up right now. He should focus on his material like NCERT. He should reread that NCERT thoroughly. But NCERT mein se, the important things like dance, the important thing like what I said about puppetry, etc., etc., specific parts, he should read from Nitin Singhania. Hope that clears the point.
So we have read 11th class Tamil Nadu board. For history.
Tamil Nadu board. That's a wonderful book, I think. That's a good book. You can focus on that. You can reread, make sure that you reread that book in these 40 days.
Yes. Sir, I have one doubt about geography.
More comprehensive than what you call as fine arts book from the NCI. As much as I know, because I had referred to certain parts of that book during my time.
Sir, I have one doubt about geography. Should we read Majid Hussain or G.C. Leong or like we should revise our own notes? Or
no, Majid Hussain to bilkul bhi mat padho abhi, theek hai. You should focus on aapke notes agar hai jo aapne padhe hain ek bari, focus on that. NCERT books padhe hain, you have read NCERT books?
Sir, NCERT geography ke liye nahi padhi hai. Sir, I have referred some different notes. I have referred some different notes. Yes, sir, NCERT.
What exactly?
Sir, exactly. Like some coaching academy ke notes hai. तो उसमें से पढ़िए।
Have you read G.C. Leong?
Mama, can you please mute yourself?
G.C. Leong, हमने yes sir, G.C. Leong sir हमने क्लास में पढ़ी है। Sir, G.C. Leong हमने क्लास में पढ़ी है, आसिफ सर ने पढ़ाया। और sir, that's why I'm really confused. Should I read Majid Hussain or G.C. Leong at this time? Or like I should I refer my like our own notes?
If you have read, if Asif Sir ne agar aapko ek baar padhaya hai G.C. Leong, I would suggest read G.C. Leong also, and plus aapke apne notes that you are saying from the coaching. I won't suggest Majid Hussain right now. Maybe Asif Sir would like to.
No sir, I have told him not to read Majid Hussain. I have asked him to read G.C. Leong for world geography, and whatever I have taught, I have referred NCERT only while teaching in the class. So the notes which I have given to you, these are based on the 11th standard NCERT. And during that class also, I have suggested all of them to study 11th standard NCERT 2. One is India Physical Environment and another is Fundamentals of the Physical Geography. So whatever I have taught you, Omar, that is based on NCERT only. So agar aapne khud se bhi agar nahi padha hai NCERT, but maine jo padha hai, that is NCERT only. So you can refer to those notes which I have studied, Omar.
So that in a way makes it more comprehensive. That it's already exhaustive in that nature. See, a general principle I'll tell you guys, you have a long way to go in this UPSC examination, and this UPSC examination is not an examination itself. It's kind of a great experience of your life. This UPSC examination preparation is an experience of its own kind. So remember one thing, don't run after everything. I always tell aspirants, don't run after everything. Have a basic understanding of the process. Have your basic check boxes ticked well, and have faith in yourself. If you run after everything, that will put too many thoughts in your mind, and then you have a tendency to get confused. So don't confuse yourself with too many things. Have faith in yourself. And remember, in an examination of this type, when everything is covered, the idea is do it as humanely as possible. Do it as what you call as religiously as possible, jo aapka basics hai, and leave rest to the examination. Remember this. Nobody goes to the prelims fully prepared. Nobody goes to the mains fully prepared. Nobody goes to the interview fully prepared. In the sense, they have every part of the syllabus covered. Because the syllabus is so huge and ambiguous, you can't have a situation when you have all the syllabus covered. But balanced approach. As I told you, in whatever section you are weak, make sure you attempt those sectional mock test papers for that. That is how you will get your, that part will be strengthened, because it should not happen that at least you have to make sure jo basic questions hai, that everybody gets right, those average difficulty level questions. You have to make sure that you also get those right in every section of UPSC examination, because getting those right keeps you in hunt. If, for example, you get the average difficulty level questions wrong, since you have not covered the basics of that part, then it kind of pushes you to the wall. It kind of pushes you to the back seat, to a disadvantageous position. So make sure you have the basics right. Make sure you revise well during this whole of the time. All right?
Yes.
As we have rightly said, two things which are mentioned, that don't attempt too much of questions and don't attempt too less of the question. So last year, we have example of both. So there was one student who was very well prepared, but she attempted only, you know, 55 to 60 questions, although she was knowing more 10 questions answer. We have that example. And we have also one more example who have attempted around 95 questions, where she got 75 correct. And because of that, you know, the remaining questions, she got it wrong. She was not qualified. And there was one student who, although she was aware about, she was very sure she will be getting 5 to 10 more correct answers, she did not attempt it. So always ask them to, you know, make an intelligible guess in the exam, the difficulty level, or according to that, make your, you know, the decision. So what I suggest, that compare the previous year cutoff. So if the difficulty level of the exam, if it is same like the previous year exam, then the cutoff will be same. And if the difficulty level is more compared to the previous year exam, then you should attempt less questions. So that's what I have suggested to them. And about the geography, which I have suggested, I told to the students many times that nowadays UPSC is not asking core geography question. They are asking an application-based geography, like geography applied in environment, geography applied in economy, geography applied in international relations. You know, like nowadays, they are asking the questions like this place is in the news, you know, that last time Mazar-e-Sharif was in the news, such type of question they're asking. So geography, what I have suggested, read core geography once and then read applied geography more, because to understand applied geography, you need to understand the basics of geography, but don't read geography again and again and again. That's what I have suggested, because geography is based for all the subjects. Like if you know geography, you can understand economy, you can understand history, you can understand international relations as well, if you can understand the economy and all. That's what I have suggested related to the geography. And as far as, you know, as I've suggested about the, you know, that how many questions should be attempted. So that's what I have suggested them. Same thing, that key, you have to take a decision in exam hall based upon, you know, you have to go through the previous year question paper. And in exam hall, you have to guess it out, whether the question paper is difficult compared to the previous year or it is easy compared to the previous year. So on that basis, we can guess the cutoff, likely cutoff, and then we can decide our number of questions which we can do that.
Exactly. For this also, I would again emphasize on this, your difficulty level, to gauge that difficulty level during the exam, take a set of 4 questions, or maybe you can take a set of 8 questions. See how many questions you are able to do. If you are able to, like, for example, do 6 questions, then you can intelligently gauge that question paper is average difficulty level or it's less difficult. For example, if you are able to attempt 4 only and you are confused about 2 and you don't know 2, so that way it gives a fair idea about this thing, because more or less most of the people, like, for example, if I go by your word, you are one of that lot who is quite like, who has put in his in the hard work, who has done things systematically, who had followed the process religiously. So you are those contenders who are like the serious contenders, or the contenders who are really in the fray. So your barometer in itself will be the barometer of the examination level. So you can do that also during the examination, consciously or subconsciously. You need not to put too much of thought in it. But yes, you can see 4 question ka set here in 4 mein se maine agar 3 kar paya, that means utna difficult nahi hai. Agar main 2 hi kar paya, 2 bar 2 questions related to 2 questions, I don't know anything, that means the question paper is 50% difficult. That means good difficulty level. Cutoff will be lesser. So that is the idea. And इसी बीच में आई टेल यू वन थिंग, दिस ईयर आई बिलीव पब्लिक हेल्थ, ऑल द स्कीम्स एंड एवरीथिंग दैट विल बी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम द करंट अफेयर्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. एग्रीकल्चर अगेन दैट विल बी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट हाँ पब्लिक हेल्थ एंड सिंस फार्मर एजुकेशन, फार्मर दिस थिंग हैज बीन ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ द टाइम, इट हैज बीन वेरी प्रॉब्लमैटिक. सो फार्मर मोमेंट ऑल्सो लाइक रिलेटेड टू एग्रीकल्चर, इट विल अगेन बी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट पब्लिक हेल्थ विल बी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो मेक श्योर यू गो थ्रू दोज पब्लिक हेल्थ स्कीम्स एटसेट्रा. द फाइनर पॉइंट्स अबाउट वैक्सीनेशन तो अच्छे से देख लिया होगा, आई डोंट सी क्या आएगा उसमें, बट हाँ पब्लिक हेल्थ स्कीम्स, बिकॉज दिस वॉज अ पब्लिक हेल्थ पैंडेमिक, पब्लिक हेल्थ स्कीम्स विल बी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो ट्राई टू फिगर आउट ऐसे ऐसे 5-6 टॉपिक्स एटलीस्ट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. यू शुड बी लाइक, यू शुड हैव दोस 5-10 टॉपिक्स इन योर माइंड, जहां से पॉसिबिलिटी है कि क्वेश्चंस ज्यादा आ सकते हैं. सिमिलरली बायोटेक्नोलॉजी फ्रॉम द फील्ड ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी विल बी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज ऑल द डिस्कशंस अबाउट वैक्सीनेशन एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स, सो बायोटेक्नोलॉजी विल ऑल्सो बी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड देन दिस विल ऑल्सो बी इंपॉर्टेंट. अगेन एनवायरमेंट इज always like that will remain important for next 2-3 years again, because climate change has again been one of the points of contention, one of the points of discussion, because you have seen again the extreme events that are happening around. So that again will be important, climate change, etc. So at least last pe aate aate, make sure you have the idea of, Asif sir can help you in that also. Again, current affairs mein se bhi, you can have at least 5, 10, 15 sections jahan pe you can emphasize more. You can thoda bahut factually, you can try to make sure ke you have more facts in your mind regarding those issues. 10, 15 topics of the current affairs.
Yes, sir. With respect to pandemic, I have given some topics, like probable topics, which I'm expecting. Like basics, mein maine unko bataya hai ki you need to know the difference between virus and bacteria, types of, you know, the vaccines. Because we can expect basic questions as well, like virus, bacteria, then, you know, vaccination, types of vaccination, as well as, you know, the role of biotechnology in vaccines, types of vaccine, etc. And with respect to public health policies, I'm expecting more questions in mains exam as well as in essay. I told them that there could be a question in essay on these public health policies as well as in mains exam. Prelims mein more of, and we are seeing that they're asking two types of questions, one or two questions based on very basic questions. And again, linked with the current affairs. That's what they're asking. And as you were discussing about the intelligible guess, which I always tell to students that those students who are getting wrong in, you know, jab wo guesswork karke jab answer nikalte hain, when they're getting it wrong, मैं उनको ये कहता हूँ कि आप बहुत ज्यादा सोचो. लाइक दोस पीपल हु थिंक टू मच, दे मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम दे गेट रॉन्ग इन द इंटेलिजिबल गेस क्वेश्चन. बहुत ज्यादा सोच कर वो आंसर को पूछते हैं. और यू नो देयर आर सम
कॉम्प्लिकेट कर
टू गेट इट करेक्ट विदाउट यू नो कुछ वाइल्ड गेस में जब उनके आंसर सही आते हैं तो वो इसलिए होता है कि वो ज्यादा सोचते नहीं. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम दैट्स व्हाट वी टेंडेंसी है. एंड एज यू राइटली सेड इन द बिगिनिंग ओनली, नो मेनी मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द टाइम्स व्हिच आई फाउंड दैट कि मेजॉरिटी ऑफ स्टूडेंट गेट रॉन्ग इन पॉलिटी. प्रॉब्लम ये होता है कि पॉलिटी की पढ़ाई बहुत ज्यादा करते हैं और जिस सब्जेक्ट की ज्यादा पढ़ाई करते हैं उसका ही ज्यादा आंसर्स गलत आता है एग्जाम. एंड मेनी टाइम्स ऐसे होता है कि जिस सब्जेक्ट को आपने ज्यादा पढ़ाई नहीं की है उसके क्वेश्चंस प्रीलिम्स में बहुत मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द टाइम्स दे गेट इट करेक्ट. सो दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव सजेस्टेड कि जो इंटेलिजेंट गेसिंग में आंसर जिनके गलत आते हैं इज बिकॉज दे आर ओवर थिंकिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव सजेस्टेड टू देम. तो ये अवॉइड करना है एग्जाम. यू हैव टू अवॉइड ओवर थिंकिंग. फर्स्ट इंस्टिंक्ट में आपको जो सही लगता है उसको एक्सेप्ट करना है. अगर आप बहुत ज्यादा सोचने लगोगे तो फिर बहुत सारी पॉसिबिलिटीज आपको ऑप्शंस में दिखने लगेंगे कि जिससे आपके आंसर गलत ही हो जाए. दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव सजेस्टेड.
एग्जैक्टली. That happens. As I told them initially also, I gave one disclaimer also. I like to emphasize on this. At times, it's like, such as the dynamics of this exams, at times you yourself self-contradict yourself. Like, for example, this is one of the points I might contradict because I told them earlier, whenever you find an easy question, try to read it twice at least. There might be some contradiction between this and this instinctual part. As I also agree with this, I also agree on this. But at times, what we think is, that since this examination is UPSC examination, if I'm getting an answer right in first go, like for example, if I feel like itna hi nahi ho sakta, there might be something else in it. So at the end of the day, we complicate and overthink. Yes, that is the problem. Overthink. But yes, through this comprehensive test series, this mock tests and all that, you should figure out, you should fathom, you should discern for yourself, and that understanding should enable you to make a decision about it. When it comes to guessing, am I good in guessing? There are some people who have a knack of making good guesses. Exactly. So it's all about you. So this UPSC examination is a mix of everything. It's all about smart work. When we talk about smart work is only this. You understand yourself. You understand your strengths and weaknesses. You play on your strengths. You try and make sure that weaknesses don't affect you too much. That's it.
So what I do, like when I'm having test, if someone has got the wrong answer, I ask them that what you have guessed while asking them, making that answer. So I just want to know what thought process he is having or she is having while attempting that question. So I ask them ki ye jo aap soch rahe ho to ye aapko exam mein nahi karna hai, because that is very important. Like ki when you are attempting any questions, what was there in your mind before attempting that question. तो वहां पर अगर वो सोचने में अगर कहीं गलती हो रही है, सो दैट्स व्हाट आई पिन पॉइंट एंड आई आस्क देम नॉट टू रिपीट इट इन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन और इन द नेक्स्ट टेस्ट. दैट्स व्हाट वी आर डूइंग. यस, दैट्स
अ गुड थिंग टू डू. यस,
यू कैन आस्क योर क्वेश्चंस मिताली.
यस सर. सो माय क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग द सीसैट पेपर. लाइक व्हाट स्ट्रेटजी यू लाइक यू फॉलोड फॉर सीसैट.
व्हाट्स योर बैकग्राउंड एग्जैक्टली. I'm not getting your name, your name is Mithali.
Mithali Sadhwani.
Your name is?
Mithali Sadhwani.
What's your background exactly?
So Sir, I've done engineering, but I'm weak in mathematics.
You're weak in mathematics. Have you attempted any question papers, mock tests for this GS, CSAT?
So previously, since it's my third attempt, so previously I have joined test series, but this time I have not joined any test series. I'm following like Asif sir is guiding to me.
So last year she has appeared this exam and she has got good marks in GS paper 1. But since she did not qualify paper 2, we presume that she did not qualify. So that was the problem. So she's very good in paper 1, but she's having some fear about CSAT. So that's what she's bothering more about.
Achha. See, at the end of the day, when it comes to quantitative ability, see, CSAT also, this part, aptitude test, has different parts in itself. For example, one is typical numerical part. That I understand you have fear of numbers, aversion with mathematics, etc. But another two parts are their logical reasoning and the what you call as language related aspect of the things. How good are you in that?
So how comfortable are you? I'm comfortable in maths even as well. But the thing is that it's just my fear that make me feel that whatever question I will attempt, it will be wrong. It's my fear that I'm not able to overcome. I'm good at English.
See, the problem.
Two passages. And the logical reasoning aspect is also like I'm okay with it. The mathematics section, I'm weak a little bit, but I can do it. Like when I gave my attempt at the exam, when on the day of the exam, like I was blank. But I when came home and solved that question, I was able to solve even the mathematics question as well. So, like, I came across that it is just my fear which I'm not able to overcome it.
Huh. Acha. Have you done any mock test papers for it? Mock papers?
So, previously I did, but this time, like, I have not. But I'm, like, solving previous question papers.
Huh? There's some kind of more, it's more psychological in your case rather than being real exactly what you have said, because quantitative ability and all that part is all about psychology. It has more a psychological element than real element. So what exactly I would suggest is don't go try and read something basic about quantitative abilities. In quantitative ability section. See, for example, there are certain chapters jahan se questions thode zyada aa jate hain. To increase your confidence right now, try and give some part, like for example, half an hour daily for 4 or 5 days to the basic theoretical part of that, to understand that. Thoda bahut. It's not about anything real. It's just, I'm trying to make sure what my point or what my purpose here is, make sure that you have confidence on your side. Confidence boost karne ke liye, thoda read that theoretical part, because most of the quantitative ability books, some quantitative ability books come with certain formula and all that, some basic understanding they'll try and provide in the basic chapter itself. Then they will move to questions. Try and read something about that. Try and find out those formulae and all that from the basic theoretical part first. Then the important aspect here is only thing that can help you increase your confidence right now is mock tests. Do one thing, section-wise mock test up karo. During this time, section-wise mock test, by that I mean to say, for example, in a week, at least fix 3 days. 3 din mein aap make sure karo, total mein you are covering whole of the CSAT in 1 week at least once. Ek din you can do quantitative ability, second day or third day after break, whatever you are comfortable with, you can do logical reasoning part, and then third day you can do the English wala part. That will help you in thought about minimizing this aspect. So you have to break it down. See, you have to understand CSAT in this way, that it's not something that is one dimensional. Even to that extent, on the day, if you are not able to attempt questions of the mathematics well, there is enough logical reasoning questions, there are enough verbal reasoning questions, etc., that will help you qualify this examination. So break it into mathematics alag, and then logical reasoning part alag, and the third part, that's more about verbal and all that, everything, English part. Break it into 3 parts and attempt those mock test papers in a week, like one quantitative, one English part, and one logical part. And you have to set it in your mind, and you have to prepare it this way. Come what may, bad mein jai, mathematics bad mein jai, English and logical reasoning, that will help you scale the examination. That's it. Got it?
Yes, sir. Sir, can you please explain what was your strategy for CSAT?
I'm regarding my strategy, since I was a non-medical student, I was a mathematics student, I never actually prepared for CSAT. But yes, whomsoever I talk about CSAT and all, I tell them, make sure, it happens only through practice, make sure you do some 4-5 mock test papers, you try to see it section wise, because what happens exactly in that CSAT paper is, for example, if you get stuck at one question, what happens, it ruins whole of your paper. You have to make your mental setup like this, ki bhai do question nahi aaye, teen question nahi aaye, char question on the trot nahi aaye, there are enough number of questions that will be easy enough for you to attempt, and that will help you to qualify this examination. See, you don't have to get stuck at one question. Give good amount of time to that question. Don't just flick through the questions. Wahan kya ho jata hai? When you start panicking and all, try to see during first 5-10 minutes, try to take this in mind. पहले 10 मिनट में मुझे अगर सॉल्व नहीं भी होते हैं क्वेश्चंस, फॉर एग्जांपल मैथमेटिक्स के क्वेश्चन सॉल्व भी नहीं होते, बट आई डोंट हैव टू डू इट लाइक दिस कि एक मिनट के बाद क्वेश्चन छोड़ दिया. यू हैव टू ट्राई, मेक श्योर यू गिव एटलीस्ट 2 मिनट्स टू दैट क्वेश्चन, नॉट मोर देन 2 मिनट्स. डोंट पैनिक इनिशियली, लाइक व्हेन इट्स द स्टार्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस, एटलीस्ट गिव 1-2 मिनट्स टू द क्वेश्चन, मे बी इट कम्स आउट. इट्स You have to find a way out, that way out in that sense. Once one question breaks for you, that will give you confidence and direction to attempt other questions. You don't have to get stuck with one question, but you don't have to leave it like this, ki bhai bas chhod diya, ab ye nahi aa raha, because that will increase your panic. Agar ek nahi aa raha, lag raha aapko difficult hai, leave it. But second wala, jo aapko lagta hai ki conceptually you are good in it, try to figure it out. Agar 2 minute bhi lage, 3 minute bhi lage, don't just flick it out. Theek hai? So do it that way. It will help you. Ek to section wise isko divide karo and attempt those mock test papers section wise. And then for mathematics, read something basic. Agar us book mein kahi jagah basic chapter mein kahi aa raha hai, thoda that will give you more confidence. Yes, I'm theoretically prepared to do it. But although it's all about attempting those questions. Theek hai?
Yes, sir. Sir, I will try this. Yeah. Thank you.
Do it like this, and since it's something in your mind, remember one thing: during the examination itself or during the mock test papers itself, ek to number ek, you don't have to get stuck with one question for too long, because there are so many questions that will be easy. See, in the CSAT paper, there will be difficulty level of the questions. Some questions will be as easy as the back of your hand, or as easy as a walk in the park. Some question will be difficult. You have to find out ki bhai, at the end of the day, I should not get stuck with only the difficult questions. You find out, spot out those easy 2-3 questions that will give you confidence and direction. How I do a difficult and leave it. You don't need every question to be attempted. You don't need to get every question right. You need only 33%, and those questions, those average difficulty level questions or easy difficulty level questions, you should be able to spot and do confidently. Bas. Any other question?
Sir, approximately what are the good number of attempts in GS paper and the CSAT paper? Just an approx number.
See, in CSAT paper, I'll talk about CSAT paper at least. CSAT paper, since 33% of the questions, 33% is the cutoff. So approximate 55% of the questions you should do. 55% mein calculation kya jaati hai? I'm not saying double exactly. I'm saying less than double. 33% will be around. Agar uska double karein, it will be again around 66%.
Yeah.
I'm saying 55-56%, because see, in that threshold, in that difference, in that stretch between 33% to 55%, there will be if, for example, half of the questions you get right, half of the questions you can get wrong. At max, it won't be more than that. Believe me, at max, half of the question you will get wrong, half of the questions you will get right in that stretch. Automatically, that will balance somewhere around 40% of the pass marks.
Okay.
So ideally, it should be around 66. But if you are one of those guys who is a little more conservative about this thing, who has the fear of attempting more questions, 55% of the questions you have to attempt.
Okay.
Got it? And...